Yo, what's going on, y'all? This is Jason McGee, and you are watching Gospel Goodies TV.
Gospel Goodies. Gospel Goodies.
This is Gospel Goodies.
As a child, did you know that you wanted to work in music? Was it like your first love?
No, actually. Theater was my first love. Acting was my first love.
Were you in any plays?
Yeah, of course. I was Santa Claus when I was five. No, I'd actually moved to LA. I moved to Los Angeles for theater school. So it wasn't music, but I've always directed the choirs at church. But I guess in my mind, it was never supposed to be a thing. It was supposed to be the thing that I did at church.
Right.
So, you know, my mother was a choir director, so I studied her. But even when I moved and when I wanted to choose my own career path, it was theater, it was acting. I saw myself on Broadway, I saw myself on TV. But, you know, all of a sudden, it's like things kind of changed, and it was always music.
Interesting. Who were some of the gospel music legends, or just music legends, you know, that you grew up with, that you wanted to, like, be like?
I'm probably the only kid in the world who studied choir directors. Like, everyone else studied singers, I didn't. It wasn't my thing. I studied choir directors. It was Orlando Draper, it was Ricky Dillard, it was Tyrone Block of the Thompson Community Singers. He's their director. Those were like my three directors. I was like, oh my God, these guys are God. You know? Then vocally, it was always Whitney Houston for me.
Oh, okay.
Always.
She's amazing.
Yeah.
What song has carried you through your career as you might have experienced ups and downs?
Donald Lawrence has a song called There Is a King in You. And that's, I remember the first time I heard that song, I was driving home to Bakersfield, California. And it's a 2-hour drive, and it was the only song I played for 2 hours. And like that song was kind of a turning point for me. Because it's more introspective, so it makes you look